reaction? Are you encouraged by what the Attorney General has so publicly said, even as his actions continue to line up with the president's priorities, especially when it comes to the Roger Stone case?
Look, Wolf, I think it's very important to question the sincerity of the Attorney General, and I think that's why the president's response was so muted. Look, this is an Attorney General who, from the day he arrived in office, has behaved as the president's defender, who thinks that his role is to defend the president of the United States, not to represent the people of this country as the Attorney General of the United States. It began with mischaracterizing the Mueller report. It began with his refusal to turn over the whistleblower report. It's now ending with giving favorable sentences or recommending favorable sentences to friends of the president, to going overseas, trying to discredit our intelligence agencies' findings about the relationship between the Trump campaign and Russia, refusing to recuse himself from a number of investigations. So, look, this attorney general is the Roy Cohen the president sought. He's behaving in a way that is protecting the president, supporting the president's friends and allies, undermining the Department of Justice, causing four attorneys to withdraw from the case and one to leave the department in its entirety. Look, the American people expect the Department of Justice to do their work in a fair and impartial way. That's why the Lady Justice is blindfolded. It cannot be that there's one set of rules for Donald Trump and his friends and another set of rules for the rest of the American people.
So how do you explain...
So this strikes at the very heart of the department.
Congressman, I understand your criticism of the Attorney General. So how do you explain what he publicly told Pierre Thomas of ABC News today, that the public statements and tweets from the president make it impossible, his words, for me to do my job? He says he's not going to be bullied or influenced by anybody, including the president. He said, I cannot do my job here at the department with a constant background commentary that undercuts me. How do you explain that?
I think what the Attorney General is saying, look, Mr. President, I'm getting everything done you want done. I'm executing all of the strategies that are protecting you from accountability, that are rewarding your friends, that are taking care of the people you want to be taken care of. I'm putting all the investigations that you have a personal interest in. I'm taking charge of those. I'm doing all the things you want me to do. I'm refusing to recuse myself from the ongoing investigation. I'm refusing to recuse myself from this issue related to Lev Parnas. I'm making a recommendation about your friend Roger Stone. So I think it was basically the Attorney General saying, look, I got this. I'm executing it. I'm doing all the things you want me to do. I'm your Roy Cohen. Don't make my job harder by tweeting about it and drawing attention
to
it.
But he could have said that privately to the president. Those are all valid points. But to do so publicly, you understand the president, he gets pretty angry at his subordinates who publicly blast him.
But you notice But you notice he didn't, because I think upon reflection, the president realized the Attorney General of the United States is working hard to protect the president. He's executed in every way the president has wanted him to. He's protecting the friends of the president and the president himself. And so I think the president gave a very muted response because...
So you think the president... You think the president blinked?
I think the president understands that the Attorney General of the United States is taking very good care of him, not advancing the best interests of the American people, but protecting the president from a lot of accountability and executing the instructions to help the president's friends and to refuse to recuse himself from investigations that are important to the president. And I think that's what matters to the president. So an offhanded statement from the Attorney General, perhaps in response to what he's hearing from the rank and file within his department, that are really demoralized by the Attorney General of the United States intervening in the sentencing of a single criminal defendant. You know, when Barr said, I thought I'm going to do what I think is right, it is very unusual for the Attorney General of the United States to interfere with a sentencing recommendation of a single defendant. That is unheard of. And he's doing that because Roger Stone's a friend of the president's and because the president tweeted about how he thought it was so unfair and Roger Stone should be treated differently. And lo and behold, the Attorney General follows that instruction. So I think they both recognize they're getting done what the president wants done and occasionally maybe grumbling about some of it and saying, don't draw so much attention to this so I can continue to act as your Roy Cohen rather than uphold the rule of law and make sure that justice impartially administered in this country very, very clear.
I suspect it wasn't an offhanded comment by the Attorney General. I suspect he thought long and hard about going so public and rebuking the President of the United States. And we saw this public statement from the White House. I suspect behind the scenes, the President is not very happy right now. But we'll see what happens. Congressman David Cicilline, always good to have you here in the Situation Room.
Thanks for having me.